Krishnaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschachyate Shatarine Panchakaupata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaivacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, today is the auspicious day of the appearance of Sri Nrisingadev. So we're going to describe the pastimes of Lord Nrisingadev today. So Lord Nrisingadev is one of the important avatars of Lord Vishnu, described in Jayadev Goswami's Das Avatar Stotra. Srila Jayadev Goswami wrote in his Gita Govinda, he begins the Gita Govinda by offering prayers to the 10 incarnations of Lord Vishnu.
Srila Jayadev Goswami,
just a minute. Okay. So, in Srimad Bhagavatam, it describes how Maharaj Yudhisthira had witnessed the soul of Sishupala leave the body. When Sishupala was killed by Lord Krishna, he saw the soul leave the body and enter into the effulgence of Lord Krishna.
在圣典摩迦瓦坛这部书当中记载到，当尤迪斯蒂尔马哈拉主，他就亲眼见证了西舒帕拉，他离开躯体的过程，他被主昆士那所杀，他进入了主昆士那的光灿。So,
Maharaj Yudhisthira understood that Sishupala had been very fortunate that he'd achieved a high level of liberation. He'd achieved Sayujimukti, merging into the effulgence of Lord Krishna.
So,
Maharaj Yudhisthira was surprised because Shishupal had been so envious of Krishna and he committed many, many offences against Lord Krishna, and it finally resulted in Lord Krishna killing him. And Maharaj Yudhisthira understood that usually great yogis only with great difficulty can achieve that kind of liberation.
Yudhisthira Maharaj 也非常明白，只有伟大的瑜伽师历经了种种的艰难困苦，最后才能达到这样的解脱。So
he thought, how is it this Shishupal, who was so envious of Lord Krishna and was so offensive, that he could get such a good destination? Because usually sinful people and atheistic people, they go to hell. But he saw Shishupal get Sayujam, get liberation.
一般来说，就是罪恶深重的人，他们死后会下地狱。但是，像但是，虚数怕了，他却得到了这样的解脱。So
Narada Muni explains to Maharaj Yudhisthira that actually Shishupal, as well as his Shishupal and his brother Dantavakra, who had both been killed by Krishna, by Lord Krishna, that in their previous lives they were actually from the spiritual world and they were associates of Lord Krishna, but they had been cursed to come to the material world.
Narada Muni 就像 Yudhisthira Maharaj 就解释了，Shishupala和他的兄弟Dantavakra，他的兄弟也被 Krishna 所杀，在他们的前一生，他们是灵性世界主 Krishna 的同游，但是因为他们兄弟俩受到诅咒，所以才来到物质世界。
So, then what happens is Maharaj Yudhisthira is surprised that how is it possible that they were in the spiritual world and they could be cursed to come to the material world. In the spiritual world they have spiritual bodies, and they come to the material world and have to take a material body.
Yudhisthira Maharaj 感到很惊讶，这兄弟俩他们原本他们是有着灵性的躯体，在灵性世界，但是他们又如何就受到诅咒，下降到物质世界，拥有了物质躯体的呢？
Maharaj Yudhisthira is surprised because usually nobody who goes to the spiritual world will come back to the material world. Not at least not devotees who've got spiritual bodies. Impersonalists, they come back. If they get liberation to the impersonal Brahma Jyoti, they can come back. Excuse me. But it's unusual for devotees to come back. We never heard of this before, Maharaj Yudhisthira says.
Mm, 所以 奉献者，回到物质世界，这是没有听说过的，而且这是非同寻常的一件事情。
Maharaj, Narada Muni explains that it's the energy, it's due to the internal potency of the Lord, it's yoga maya, and the effect of yoga maya is not mahamaya, which brought them to the material world, but it was under the arrangement of the Supreme Lord. There was some purpose of the Lord in these two men coming from the spiritual world into the material world.
Narada Muni 就解释了，这是实际上是由于Yoga Maya 的能量，不是 Maha Maya 的能量，使他们从物质世界来到从灵世界到了物质世界，这是至尊主的一种特殊的安排，让这两个人呢从灵性世界进入到物质世界。
So the Lord actually had a purpose. His purpose was he wanted to fight. He wanted to enjoy a fight. And when the Lord fights, he can't just fight anybody. So he arranges for some of his devotees to come to leave the spiritual world and come to the material world. And then he arranges that they're given special powers so that they can give him a good fight. And in this way, the Lord becomes satisfied.
主这么做呢，他是有他自己的目的的。主希望能享受战斗的乐趣，因为他不能随便跟任何人来作战，所以他要安排奉献者离开灵性世界，来到物质世界。来到这个他需要特殊的奉献者来实现的他这个计划，这样呢，好跟他们好好打一仗，他自己就能够得到满足。
So the Supreme Lord arranged that the four Kumaras would come to the spiritual world, and at the entrance to the spiritual world, they were stopped by the two doorkeepers named Jai and Vijay. And Jai and Vijay challenged them that, why are you coming here? Do you have the right to come here? You're just young children. Is it possible that you're qualified to enter here?
就安排库马尔斯兄弟又来到灵性世界，他们在灵性世界的大门入口处呢，就被灵性世界的两个看门人阻挡住了，扎亚和维扎亚，他们就对库马尔斯兄弟说，你们都是小孩子，你们为什么来到这个灵性世界，你们有什么权利，有什么资格呢？
Now the four Kumaras are the eldest sons of Lord BrahmaBut they appear just like young children. But Jai and Vijay did not give them any respect. Jai and Vijay challenged them, that why are you coming here? So they became angry and they cursed Jai and Vijay.
Kumar 四兄弟呢，本来是主 Brahma 的四个儿子，但是他们就是以小孩子的形体出现。Jaya 和 Vijaya 呢？就并没有向他们表示出尊敬，反而挑衅地说道，你们为什么来这里？所以库马尔兄弟很生气，诅咒了他们俩。
So they were cursed, they would go to the material world, and they would take three births as demons.
因此他们就被诅咒进入物质世界，投生为恶魔，投生三次。
So their first birth was in the womb of Diti, and Diti is one of the wives, Kashyapa. Kashyapa has many wives, and one of them was Diti. So Diti, she approached her husband for union with him at an inauspicious time.
所以兄弟，这兄弟俩的第一世， 他们就投生到低级的子宫当中。低级是卡夏塔穆尼的其中许多的妻子当中的其中一位，而低级呢就接近了卡夏塔穆尼，在一个非常不吉祥的时刻想要跟圣人结合。
So Kashyapa had tried to restrain his wife, but he was not able to, and he ended up satisfying her lusty desire. But after the union, he told his wife that because you approached me at this time in the night, which is inauspicious, the result will be the child in your womb will be a demon. And he'll give trouble to the universe. He'll give trouble to innocent women, and he'll give a lot of trouble to the universe.
Kashyapa Muni 就试图要阻止他的妻子，但是他没能成功，他只好满足了这位妻子的色欲。但是在跟他结合之后呢，Kashyapa Muni 就告诉他，因为你在这个傍晚，在这种不吉祥的时分呢，你怀了孕，所以你生下的孩子将会是恶魔，他们会给这个宇宙带来麻烦，会给无辜的妇女也找麻烦。
But Kashyapa then also told his wife that finally, child will be killed by the Supreme Lord.
Kashyapa Muni 也告诉妻子，最终这两个孩子将会被至尊主所杀。
So this was something, this helped to pacify the mind of Diti, that when she heard that her son was going to be killed by the Lord, she understood that would be a good thing, that would be for his benefit. Although he would perform many atrocities in his life, ultimately he'd be killed by the Lord, and that is beneficial. That is what would give him liberation.
这段话呢，好歹就让 Diti 呢感到内心得到了一些安慰和抚慰，他就明白他的孩子最终被至尊主所杀，这是对这个孩子有好处，会给他们带来益处。即便他们就做了很多的暴行，但是他们最终被至尊主杀死之后会得到解脱。
Diti kept the child in her womb for a long time because she understood that once a child takes birth, it's going to give a lot of trouble. So for about a period of 100 years, she kept the child in her womb because this was Satya Yuga. People lived a long time. So she could keep the child in her womb for a long time. At the time of her giving birth, there were many inauspicious omens. The sky became very black, and there was thunder and lightning. There was a big storm. Many trees were knocked down. These are all very inauspicious omens that a demon is taking birth. And it happened that Diti gave birth to two sons. One was named Hiranyakashipu, and the other was named Hiranyaksha.
在这两个孩子出生的时候呢，就显示了许多不祥的征兆，天空一片乌云密布，有雷鸣电闪，大雨倾盆，许多的巨树就忽然倒下，这些都是恶魔降生的不祥的征兆。结果呢，丁提就生下了两个儿子，一个名叫伊恩亚卡什布，一个叫伊恩亚克沙。
Together, these two brothers terrorized the universe. They went everywhere, creating a lot of trouble. Hiranyaksha was digging up the earth, trying to get gold everywhere, and eventually the earth fell out of its position in orbit in the universe and sank, went to the bottom of the Garbhodak, went into the Garbhodak ocean in the bottom of the universe.
这个兄弟俩一起就给这个宇宙制造了很多恐怖的事件，带来很多麻烦。提山亚克什的这个儿子呢，他就掘地三尺，试图逃黄金出来，所以最后他把地球运到了蕴淡之洋的海底。
Then Lord Varaha appeared, coming. Swayambhuva Manu approached Lord Brahma, and Lord Brahma had asked Swayambhuva Manu and his wife to procreate offspring and to improve the population in the universe. But Swayambhuva Manu said, the earth has fallen into the bottom of the universe, so we should pick the earth up. First, the earth should be restored to its proper position. And at that time, Lord Varaha appeared from the nostril of Lord Brahma.
得到了 Brahma 的指令，命令他要还原宇宙的人口。然后斯万央布瓦曼努就对 Brahma 说：“那地球掉到了蕴淡之洋的海底。” 首先，我们必须得把地球，救回来，让它回到它正常的轨道上。这时候呢，Varaha就从 Brahma 的鼻孔当中就生出来了。Lord
Varaha was very small initially, but very quickly he grew to an enormous size.
主 Varaha 一开始起初它是很微小的，逐渐逐渐的，它就把自己扩展到了巨大的形象。There
are two descriptions of Varaha. One is a white color and one is a red color.
经典描述有两Varaha。 有两个Varaha，一个是白色的，一个是红色的Varaha。
Some commentators explain that Lord Varaha did two functions. One was fighting with Hiranyaksha and killing him. The other was picking up the earth from the bottom of the universe. So it's explained that these two events have happened at different times, but in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it appears Vyasadeva has combined the two pastimes into one.
瓦拉哈的出现有两个目的，一个是和伊丹亚克沙作战，第二个目的是要捡起地球。所以在不同的时间就在不同。 Lord Varaha carried out this two missions in two different times.
Yes, but the commentators, Srila Vyasadeva and Srimad Bhagavatam, combined the two pastimes into one. Lord Varaha killed Hiranyaksha and picked up the earth and put the earth back in position. When Lord Varaha killed Hiranyaksha, his brother Hiranyakashipu was very angry.
就杀死了恶魔Hiranyaksha，然后又从蕴淡之洋拾起了地球。Hiranyaksha的兄弟Hiranyakashipu就对主Varaha非常的愤怒。Srimad
Bhagavatam describes how Hiranyakashipu had to pacify the wife of Hiranyaksha and his children, as well as the mother, Diti, because Hiranyaksha was one of her sons. And Hiranyakashipu spoke very nice philosophy, pacifying their minds.
描述 Hiranyakashipu， 他就安慰了 Hiranyaksha， 他的妻子、孩子以及他们的母亲 Diti， 因为 Hiranyaksha， 因为他的儿其中一个儿子被杀死了，所以 Hiranyakashipu 就对他们讲述了娓娓动听的哲学，安抚了他们的心意。
Hiranyakashipu，although he was a demon, he had knowledge of the soul. He understood that we're not the body. And he understood at the time of death, the soul leaves the body and the subtle body goes with the soul and they will take another body.
Hiranyakashipu 虽然是一名恶魔，但他却理解有关于灵魂的哲学。他明白当死亡之际，精微的躯体就会携带着灵魂离开粗糙的躯体，进入下一个躯体当中。
Hiranyakashipu had this knowledge, and he was explaining the science of transmigration of the soul from one body to another. We should understand that by this that the demons.Have good knowledge. The only thing is they're against the supremacy of the Lord, and they will always oppose the Lord and the demigods.
Hiranyakashipu, 他了解，他拥有知识，了解关于轮回的科学，躯体的知识。他明白这一切，他虽然拥有恶魔，虽然拥有知识，但是他们却反对至尊主的至高无上的权威，他们反对至尊主，也反对半神人。
They recognize that within the body there's the soul and the super soul, but they don't want to surrender to the super soul. That is the problem. They don't want to surrender to the Lord.
恶魔们，他们承认，在躯体当中有灵魂，也有超灵，但是他们却不愿意臣服于超灵，这是他们的问题所在。他们不愿意臣服。
So we learn from Bhagavad Gita, there are two kinds of people. There is the divine, and there are the demoniac. Hiranyakashipu represents the demoniac.
佛家梵歌当中，我们明白有两类人，一种是神圣品质的，一种是恶魔品质的。Hiranyakashipu他代表着恶魔品性。
Those who are divine are demigods, and they're associated with the mode of goodness. The demons are associated with the mode of passion and ignorance.
那些品性神圣的人，他们是半神人。他们与善良属性联谊，而恶魔品性的是与畸形属性以及愚昧属性联谊的人。
When Hiranyakashipu heard how Lord Vishnu had killed his brother, Hiranyaksha vowed that he was going to kill Lord Vishnu in revenge.
Hiranyakashipu 听到他兄弟的死讯，被主维什努所杀，他就发誓。
And Hiranyakashipu spoke about drinking the blood. After he cuts off Vishnu's head, he was going to drink the blood from his head. And he spoke about how his own brother Hiranyaksha used to enjoy sucking blood.
Hiranyakashipu 发誓在把主威士努的头颅砍下之后，要喝主威士努的鲜血，因为他的兄弟以前就喜欢吸血。
It is the nature of the demons that they're fond of meat eating and sucking blood.
这就是恶魔本性，他们喜欢吃肉喝血。
They won't even care to protect the cows. Rather, they will kill the cows and eat the flesh and drink the blood.
他们甚至不在乎，他们就会去杀母牛，吃牛肉，喝牛血。
It's the most sinful thing to do. If you kill cow, it's very, very sinful. You will suffer for many lifetimes in hell.
杀牛是非常罪恶深重的，因为这种罪恶要去地狱，生生世世的受苦。
The cow is a gentle creature associated with the mode of goodness. The cow eats some grass and gives the most valuable foodstuffs in the form of milk.
牛是最性格温和的动物，它们是善良属性的。牛会吃草，但是却提供最珍贵的食物。这种食物就是以奶的形式出现的食物。
Milk is the the blood of the cow transformed into milk, which is meant for the well-being, for the sustenance of the human body.
牛的奶是他们的血液的一种转化物，乳牛就会以牛奶的形式，一共维持人体生命的这种必需品。
We know whenever a child is born, the only food they can take is milk. Usually they'll drink the milk from the mother's breast, and gradually they will drink the milk from the cow, because the cow is also like a mother.
大家都知道，当孩子婴儿出生的时候，他们唯一可以吃的食物就是奶。他们刚刚降生的时候会喝母奶，随着他们渐渐长大成人，他们就从母奶转移到喝牛奶，所以乳牛被认为就像母亲一样。
Hiranyakashipu wanted to get revenge on Lord Vishnu, and he asked all of his other demon friends that they should go to earth and they should create a lot of trouble and destroy all the holy places and stop all the yajnas performed by the great sages.
Hiranyakashipu 伺机要报复主威士奴，他就召唤来他的恶魔朋友们，命令他们去地球，给地球制造麻烦，毁灭那里的圣地，停止那里的祭祀，并且给那些圣者们找麻烦捣乱。
And they told his demon friends that they should destroy all the forests because the great sages are residing there and doing their austerities and performing yajnas there. And they should also destroy the homes of all these people who are taking care of the cows and give trouble to them.
Hiranyakashipu
purpose was to stop the sacrifices made for the pleasure of Lord Vishnu. All the sacrifices are done to satisfy Lord Vishnu. But Hiranyakashipu thought Vishnu is the enemy of our family. He killed my brother. We have to get revenge on him. We should not allow these people to do any sacrifices for Vishnu.
Hiranyakashipu的目的就是阻止对主威士努的祭祀，因为这些献祭是目的就是为了满足威士努。但是Hiranyakashipu认为主威士努是他们家族的仇敌，他要为自己的兄弟报仇，所以他不允许举行对主威士努的祭祀。
With the help of all of his demon friends, they stopped all the sacrifices, and in this way the demigods in heaven, they were not getting any offerings. So the demigods also were suffering, and there was nothing being offered to them. They left their place and they came down to earth to find out what was going on, what was happening.
Meanwhile,
Hiranyakashipu wants to get more power for himself. So he goes off to the mountains to do austerities.
与此同时，伊扎尼亚哈希布也想为自己积蓄力量，因此他就去了山里从事苦行。
Austerity can be performed in the mode of goodness, in the mode of passion, or in the mode of ignorance. Hiranyakashipu, his austerity was in the mode of ignorance. He was torturing his body, and he was trying to get, his motive was to get some foolish material benediction.
苦行可以分为善良属性的苦行、激情属性苦行以及愚昧属性的苦行。虽然他师父的苦行就是属于愚昧属性，因为他折磨自己的躯体，而且他的动机是非常不好的动机。
He did austerities for such a long time that the ants came and they ate all the flesh on his body. There were only the bones, only the skeleton remaining, but still he was standing there. And an ant hill formed around his body.
Hiranyakashipu就履行了长期的苦行，蚂蚁吃掉了他的肌肉，最后只给他留下了他的一具骷髅骨骼，但是他依然就站在那里。最后，这些蚂蚁就形成了蚁山，把他整个的躯体都啃光了。
So, Hiranyakashipu was petitioning Lord Brahma to give him benedictions. So finally, after a long, long time, Lord Brahma came there, and with his water pot, Kamandalu, he poured the special water onto the bones of Hiranyakashipu and gave him a rejuvenated body. And then Hiranyakashipu began to ask for a request from Brahma. His main desire was that he should be immortal. But Brahma told him that I can't give you that. He said, I'm also not immortal. I also have to die. I have to give up my body. I'm only temporary in this world. Although I live a long time, it's temporary. And I will have to give up my body. So I can't give you a benediction. of a power which I don't have myself. Then Hiranyakashipu tried some tricks and he asked for benedictions that he could not be killed in the day or in the night, and he should not die on the land or in the air and in the sea, and he should not die by, he should not be killed by any man or god, any man or demigod, and he should not be killed by any weapon. So many different benedictions he asked, and Lord Brahma gave these blessings.
其实呢，他师父呢，就想方设法的，想出了种种的花招，从鲁布拉玛那里得到祝福。他恳求得到祝福，不在白天死，也不在黑夜死，不在陆地死，也不被扔被杀死，也不被扔半神所杀，不会被任何武器所杀。最后，鲁布拉玛就给予了他这些祝福。
In this way, Hiranyakashipu was thinking he'd been successful, and he began to conquer the demigods, and he took control of the heavenly planets, and all the demigods were serving him. Even saints like Narada Muni was giving service to Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu had a wife, and his wife had conceived a child, and he'd given this child the name Prahlad. Now this wife, while she was pregnant, Hiranyakashipu had gone away to do his austerities. And at that time, the demigods had arrested Hiranyakashipu's wife. And they were thinking that when she gives birth to this child, we have to kill this child. Because if we don't, the child will be a big demon like his father. Will be trapped. So better we kill the child when he's born, then we don't have to have trouble with him as he grows up.
提亚亚喀什布，他的妻子，怀孕了。当，他的妻子怀孕了，他就给他的孩子起名叫普拉。所以当他妻子怀孕之际，提亚亀什布就去午休去了。半神人们就趁此机会，就逮捕了他的妻子，就心想，一旦这孩子生下之后，就立刻杀死他。
At that time, Narada Muni came and he told the demigods that you cannot do anything to this child. This child is very special, he's very powerful, that even you say you want to kill him, you won't be able to kill him, and you don't have to fear him. Because he's a great devotee of the Lord, I can assure you that this child is going to be a great devotee and he's not going to give you any trouble.
Narada Muni 就来了，他就告知半神人，不要对这个孩子采取行动，因为这个孩子是一个特殊的灵魂，他非常有力量，即便半神人想杀他，也杀不得他。 而且半神人们无需害怕，因为他以后会成为伟大的奉献者。他们可以放心，这位
In this way, Narada Muni took custody of the wife of Hiranyakashipu and he brought her to his ashram. And while she was in the ashram of Narada Muni, Narada Muni was regularly reading the scriptures and she would be hearing. And the child in the womb would also hear. And the child in the womb got tremendous purification by hearing all the scriptures read by Narada Muni. Although the child was in the womb, he developed his full Krishna consciousness.
Narada Muni 就送读经典，吉拉喀什布的妻子和他腹中的胎儿就一起聆听这些经典，每天他们聆听之后就得到了净化，所以那在这个子宫当中的婴儿他就得到了发展了全然的Krishna之觉。
His wife did not give birth to the child until her husband finished the austerities. She kept the child in her womb so long as her husband was doing austerities. When he finished his austerities and came back, at that time she delivered the child. Hiranyakashipu is very happy to have a son, and he arranged for his son to be put, as he grew up, he put him in the Gurukula, not a Gurukula for transcendental knowledge, but a Gurukula for material education with other demons. Prahlad, the child of Hiranyakashipu, was taught how to rule and how to govern and how to deal with your enemies. However, Prahlad Maharaj was already Krishna conscious, and whenever he got the opportunity, he would teach all the children in the school not to waste their time playing football and playing other ball games, but he would teach them the importance of cultivating Krishna consciousness.
但是普拉德呢，他早已就拥有了Krishna知觉，所以他在学校呢，就趁这个机会，就教导了那些孩子们，告诉他们不要浪费宝贵的光阴，去踢足球，去玩这些游戏。重要的是要培养Krishna知觉。Hiranyakashipu,
after some time, brought his child and wanted to know from his child what he'd been learning at school. But when Prahlad was asked this, then Prahlad replied that he learned that the best thing is to engage in hearing and chanting the glories of Lord Vishnu. And this made Hiranyakashipu very angry because he said Vishnu is the enemy of our family.
过了一段时间，吉拉喀什库就命令人把他的孩子就带了回来，他就想询问一下孩子在学校的学业，所以他就问了普拉德。普拉德的回答是：最好的教育是聆听、唱诵威士诺的荣耀。吉拉喀什库听了之后勃然大怒，因为威士诺是他们家族的仇敌。
Hiranyakashipu was very surprised to hear this from his son, because he'd been very careful to keep his son away from any devotees and from any saintly people. He wanted his son to grow up to be a perfect materialist and fully in the bodily conception of life.
Prahlad
Hiranyakashipu knew the principle, the importance of association. And he knew that whatever people you associate with, you will reflect their qualities. So he could not understand how Prahlad had become so a devotee to Lord Vishnu. Something wrong with your mic, maybe, Guru Mani. Oh, me, it's my one. My connection unstable. Okay. All right, so Hiranyakashipu called for the teachers of Prahlad and challenged them, that what are you teaching my child? So they denied. They said, no, we didn't teach him anything about Vishnu. We're not teaching this. We don't know where he got this from. And so Hiranyakashipu told the teachers, then take very good care of my son and be sure that he doesn't get any contact with any devotees.
Hiranyakashipu呢，就召唤来了Prahlad的老师，然后就质问他们，到底在学校教了他的儿子教了些什么知识？他的老师Prahlad的老师就矢口否认，说没有，我们没有教他任何有关于Vishnu的知识，我们不知道他从哪里获得了这些知识，所以Hiranyakashipu呢，就下令一定要对他的儿子实施严厉的监管。
But Prahlad Maharaj was still preaching to all the friends in his class, all the other demons in the school, and he was making them all devotees. So after some time, the teachers had to go to Prahlad's father, Hiranyakashipu, and tell him that this son of yours is making all the other boys devotees. They're all becoming attached to Krishna and Vishnu, and we don't know what to do about this.
与此同时，Prahlad Maharaj继续就向他的朋友们传播这个知识。他在课间课下的时候，就把这些恶们的儿子们，就告诉他们。 有关这门知识，他就发展了更多的奉献者们。然后这个Prahlad的老师呢，最后不得已就回去找到了Hiranyakashipu，就告诉他，你的儿子呢，他的同学都变成了奉献者，是他们都成为了依附 Krishna、 依附 Vishnu 的人，我们不知道该如何是好。So
Prahlad was asked. Prahlad was brought to Hiranyakashipu, and Hiranyakashipu asked Prahlad, where did you get this from? Who's been teaching you all of this about Krishna and Vishnu? And Prahlad Maharaj nicely explained, he said that you don't get Krishna consciousness just by your own efforts. You have to get the mercy of a devotee.
Prahlad 从哪里获得的这门知识，到底是谁教授了他有关于 Krishna 和 Vishnu 的知识，和他的就好的也是了。你是不能通过自己个人的努力得到 Krishna 知觉的，一定要透过奉献者的仁慈才能得到。
So Hiranyakashipu wanted to have Prahlad killed. He said, "There's no hope for this child. He's, you know, he's beyond any hope. We have to kill him." And he ordered his servants to try to kill him. But they tried so many different ways to kill him, but he couldn't be killed. He couldn't be harmed.
最后，Hiranyakashipu 就下决心要杀死自己的儿子，因为他的儿子已经没有指望了，所以就需要杀死他。提拉喀什库就命令他的仆人杀死弗拉，他的仆人就想方设法要杀死弗拉，但是他们却不能杀死他。
They tried so many things. They had this mad elephant trample over him. They put him in a pit with poison snakes. They tried to use spears to stab him. They threw him off a mountain. They threw him into the sea. No matter what they did, nothing could harm him.
他们呢，就把他放在巨象的脚下，想要让巨象踩死他，把他投进那个蛇坑，让这些毒蛇想要咬，让毒蛇咬死他，又用他们的刀叉剑子就刺穿他，想要用这种方法杀死他。他们也把他从高山之巅扔下去，想摔死他，啊，想把他投到大海当中淹死他，但是都不能伤害他的意思。毛发不能伤害弗拉。
Then Hiranyakashipu could understand this child of his was very special, and somehow he was being protected, and nothing could harm him. So Hiranyakashipu himself decided to deal with Prahlad, and he asked Prahlad, "Where is this god of yours? You say worship Vishnu. Where is he?"
Hiranyakashipu 最终就明白了，这个孩子是一个特殊的灵魂，他得到了保护，没办法伤害他，所以他就决定自己亲自动手杀他。他问弗拉德：“你的神在哪里？你崇拜的这位为什么？他是谁？他在哪里？”
Prahlad Maharaj told his father, "He's everywhere, father. He's everywhere. He's in everything."
他的父亲为什么他无他不
是 It was at that time Hiranyakashipu then asked Prahlad, "Is he in this pillar?" And he took his sword and he cut the pillar. Can you hear me, Gurumani? Gurumani, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear. Yes, I can hear.
Okay, because line is unstable a bit here. So he asked Prahlad, "Is he in this pillar?" And Prahlad said, "Yes, he's also there. He's everywhere." And so then Lord Nrisingadeva appeared from the pillar and fought with Hiranyakashipu.
就是在这个此时此刻，Hiranyakashipu他就问弗拉德，他在不在这个柱子里？然后弗拉德说，是的，他就在这个柱子当中。然后他师傅就拔出了他的剑，就挥剑砍这个柱子。就是在这个时候，从弥沙内就从柱子当中显现了，跟提拉喀什库展开了激战。
So then there was a great fight.Between Hiranyakashipu and Lord Narasimha Dev. And Hiranyakashipu was finally killed by by Lord Narsingadev. Lord Narsingadev waited until the actual time for the end of the day and the beginning of the night, because there was a benediction that he could not be killed in the day or in the night. So he waited right for the junction of the day and the night. And at that time, Lord Narsingadev picked up Hiranyakashipu, laid him across his lap and ripped open his chest and took out his intestines and put his intestines round his neck like a flower garland.
就等到了这个特定时间，等到白天结束的时候，夜晚即将开始的这个中间的阶段，等到这个白天和傍夜晚交界的傍晚的时分，他就杀死了大恶魔提那喀什布，把他放在自己的腿上，撕开了他的胸膛，并且把这恶魔的内脏 掏出来，像花环一样戴在自己的脖子上。
Lord Narsingadev was very angry because he had seen his devotee Prahlad put through so many tests and so many unpleasant dealings that Hiranyakashipu tried to have his son killed in so many ways. So this greatly angered Lord Narsingadev. And when Lord Narsingadev came, then he fought with Hiranyakashipu, he killed him. And after he killed Hiranyakashipu, then all the soldiers of Hiranyakashipu came. And Lord Narsingadev fought all of them and killed all of them. So he was very passionate, his passion was aroused and he was greatly angry. And nobody could pacify him.
奉献者就被置于种种的这种磨难、劫难和考验当中，所以主神他贝特别的生气，因为普拉德他经历的那种令人不愉快的这种磨难，所以这就激怒了主神他贝特，他就和比拉卡西普作战，杀死了他。那最后那些他的 他的比拉卡西普的他手下的士兵也都纷纷上前来，和主尼沙贝作战，最后也被死杀死了。主尼沙贝呢，在处在一种非常激情的状态当中，因为他特别的被激怒了，很生气，没有人能够平息他的怒气。
So all of the demigods, first of all, Lakshmi, the consort of Lord Narsingadev, because Lord Narsingadev is Vishnu, so the consort of Lord Vishnu is Lakshmi. So Lakshmi is like the wife of Lord Narsingadev, and she came before Lord Narsingadev, but even she could not pacify him. And then so many other demigods also came, Brahma, and Shiva, and different devas, they all came. But none of them could pacify Lord
Narsingadev。主维士努的伴侣是拉克米，所以他的妻子，甚至连他的妻子拉克米也不能平息主尼山贝普的怒气。最后，Brahma、Shiva这样的主要的办事人，他们也无法让主尼山贝普的怒气平息下来。
Then it was decided that Prahlad should try. And when they brought Prahlad in front of Lord Narsingadev, then Lord Narsingadev became pacified. And Prahlad offered his obeisances to Lord Narsingadev. And Lord Narsingadev placed his palm or his paw on the head of Prahlad Maharaj. And in this way, he gave him all spiritual knowledge, all transcendental knowledge, so that Prahlad could offer prayers to Lord Narsingadev.
最后, 就决定把不辣的就推到主尼沙德友的面前，放在他的面前。主尼沙德友看见不辣的，他的怒气渐渐的平息下来，平息最后安静了下来。不辣的呢，就向主尼沙德友致以顶拜。主尼沙德友就把他的爪子，或者是手掌，就放在了不辣的的额头上，这样就赐予他超然的知识。不辣的就可以开始向他供奉祷文。
So Prahlad begins by explaining his own situation, that he's born in a very materialistic family. He's very contaminated by birth because he was born in the family of demons. So he has, and also he explains that he's also a child, so he cannot be expected to do very much by way that he's not going to be very philosophical. He wonders if he's actually qualified to speak to Lord Nrisingadev.
Prahlad 呢，开始就解释自己的处境，称自己的是出生在物质主义的家庭，从生下来就受到了污染，因为他诞生在恶魔的家庭，而且他也解释说他自己是一个孩子，对于哲学并没有很深入的了解。
Yeah, at the time of this event, Prahlad Maharaj was only a child of 5 years old. But by the grace of Lord Nrisingadev's transcendental touch, all spiritual knowledge was put into him, and Prahlad went on to offer beautiful prayers and nice poetry, and he glorified Lord Nrisingadev, and then he described also. Prahlad Maharaj says that he's not anxious for his own liberation. He said whenever he wants, he can just chant the holy name of the Lord. But he's concerned about others who are working hard trying to enjoy material life, and he would like to benefit them.
This event happened when Prahlad was a 5-year-old child.但是由于主尼沙德友的超然的触碰，超然知识就被得以注入他的，灌注到他内心，他可以开始供奉美丽的祷文，他就说出了优美的诗节来荣耀主尼沙德友。而且布拉德称他自己并不渴望自身的解脱，因为他随时都可以唱诵主的圣名，但是他很关注别人。关心那些日夜辛勤工作、努力的享受物质的人，他希望这样的生物也能得到好处。
So Lord Nrisingadev was very pleased with Prahlad's prayers, and he asked Prahlad that please take some benediction from me. But Prahlad says, "Oh, just I said I'm not a businessman. I'm not."Serving you, I'm not your devotee just to get something in return. He said, that's business. He said, I'm not a businessman. He said, I'm satisfied simply to have devotion to you. So Lord Nrisingadev, however, is insisting that no, you please ask for some benediction.It's only proper. You must take some benediction from me. So Prahlad Maharaj said, please bless me that in my heart there will be no desire for material enjoyment. Please give me that benediction. So Lord Nrisingadev blessed Prahlad like that.
But 你请你引提出一个祝福吧，这才是正确的。你要求一个祝福，弗拉德就说，那好，那就请你祝福我的，在我的内心没有任何物质享受的欲望，请你给我这样的祝福。
Then Prahlad also thinks about his father, that my father was very offensive. He fought with you and tried to kill you. So I'm worried that maybe he's gone to hell. So could you bless my father that he won't have to go to hell? And Lord Narsingadev said, oh, you don't have to worry. He said, because you are his devoted son and because you're a pure devotee, not only is your father delivered, but all of your forefathers for many generations, they're all delivered.
Prahlad 就想起了他的父亲，他对文山大夫说，我的父亲他对你做了很多的冒犯，而且他和你作战想杀死你，他担心呢自己的父亲会下地狱，所以他就恳求文山大夫祝福他的父亲不要下地狱。普尼沙利武就安慰他，告诉弗拉德不要担心，因为他这个父亲得到这个奉献者的儿子，而且他的儿子有这样纯粹的奉爱，所以不仅他的父亲，而且他的许多代的祖先都得到拯救了。
And we see after Prahlad Maharaj, his grandson is Bali Maharaj. So Bali Maharaj had conquered the heavenly planets, had become taken over the heavenly planets from the demigods, but later Lord Vamanadeva came and took away the heavenly planets from Bali Maharaj and gave them back to the demigods. But Bali Maharaj was not killed or he was not harmed because he's the grandson of Prahlad. He's a descendant of Prahlad Maharaj, and Lord Narsingadeva, the Lord is careful to respect the promise given to Prahlad, that not only he, but all of his forefathers and descendants, they would all be devotees, they would all be at least protected, they wouldn't go to hell.
Prahlad 的孙子 Bali Maharaj， 他后来是征服了四面八方，征服了很多的星球，征服了半神人。但是主 Vamanadeva 呢，就把这个 Bali Maharaj 的财产都拿走，归还给了半神人。但是他没有伤害 Bali Maharaj， 没有杀他，因为 Bali Maharaj 是 Prahlad 的孙子后代，所以至尊主小心翼翼的就尊敬了主尼沙德的承诺，就不仅 Prahlad 的祖先，而且他的后代也都得到保护，不至于下地狱。
Okay, so we will stop here now, and we'll ask if there's any questions.
那我们讲课就到这里，接下来我们回答问题。第一个问题是 Shruti Rupa Devadasi， 明白Guru和老师们，感恩Guru的无限仁慈，您的教导和训示是我们灵性生命得以成长和延续的最好最重要保障，祈祷主尼山Devi照顾好Guru身体健康，早日回中国。还有四个问题。第一个，有新人问：一，佛法在临终关怀的时候，建议至少三天不要触碰亡者身体，因为担心他的五大元素分解时的疼痛引起嗔恨心，去不好的地方。为什么 Krishna 拒绝当天就活化亡者的躯体呢？
Okay, translate the one question.
The first question is.In Buddhism, they suggest that when somebody dies, don't touch the body who don't touch the body. They are afraid the five elements when dissolved will cause pain. Pain will make the person painful, and maybe the person will be hateful and go to not so nice place. That why in Krishna consciousness they will burn the body at the same day when the people dies.
Yes, that's a Vedic culture, that the same day the body should be burned. That if the person dies in the morning, before the sun sets, he must be burned or buried. And if he dies in the night, before the sun rises, he should be burned or should be buried. Why? So that the soul can be detached from the dead body, so that the soul can move off and go to this next situation, next destination.
按照北达问回答的话呢，是要在当天，比如说，如果这个人是在早上去世的，那就要在日落之前就把他的躯体火化或者是放入土中；如果这个人是在晚上去世的，就要在日出之前，把他的躯体火化或入土。为什么呢？就是这样，灵魂不要依附他的躯体，不要依附这个已经死去的尸体。
The Buddhist way, you're keeping that soul, you're keeping the soul there with the body so many days, the body's already dead, and you're keeping the soul, you're keeping the subtle body and the soul there with that dead body. It's not good.
在佛教当中呢，他们就把灵魂，就是让灵魂和这个死尸还待在一起，这个精微躯体以及灵魂和死尸仍然待在一起，这是不好的。That's
why you get so much trouble with ghosts and things and evil spirits in your Buddhism. You're always problem with ghosts.
就是因为这个原因。
所以呢，就会有很多鬼魂和那个邪恶的精灵找的麻烦。All right, what's the next?
The second question. 既然灵魂是永恒灵性的，为什么连天生带着 Krishna 奉献着提拉克出生的婴儿？ 也表现出和母中受过困惑的灵魂还是一样呢？对一切都无知无助，在什么情况下或者需要什么样的引导，才能让这样的孩子展现并且更好的延续他前世的Krishna知觉呢？ But since the soul is eternal spiritual, why those newborn babies who have born with tila on their forehead? They exhibit the same situation like those of the baby who are the ordinary bewildered baby, and they seem to be in ignorance and in a helpless situation. So under what situation should we guide them so that such children can manifest and continue their the previous
Krishna consciousness? Well, children, if they're born in the family of devotees, then it's going to be natural for them to continue their Krishna consciousness because the family are devotees. So that every day the family are devotee, they're worshipping Krishna and they're eating prasadam and they're chanting the holy name. So the child is in that association, and by that association, the child will also develop these habits.
She asked why those devotee babies appears like the ordinary child.
They appear like what?
Seems to be helpless. They appear like helpless and ignorant and bewildered ordinary children.
But they're born in devotee families.
When they are born, they have a tilak on their head. But they seem to be situated in a very helpless situation.
In a very what situation?
Bewildered.
They seem to be situated in a bewildered situation.
Helpless, ignorant.
Well, that's only your judgment. You have to look. You cannot just go by what you look. You have to see what people are doing, and what they're saying. You don't just go by what they look. What people look like, that's not proper judgment. Somebody may look very intelligent, but he may speak like a fool. So you have to hear what people are saying. Then you can understand. So the child is born in a situation, if it's a family of devotees, they will call, if they're born with tilak on their forehead, but it's very auspicious. It means that in their previous life they must have had connection with devotees. And they're continuing. They've taken birth in the devotee family to continue Krishna consciousness. Okay, next question.
It's the third of our group holding association in the trying to have association in the it seems like a Buddhist Sun Temple. The content including Ashtanga yoga and scripture reading, sharing, kirtan, and food, and we used vegetarian food in the Buddhist temple after offering, and we will honor this kind of prasad. So using this method is easy to attract more people. So we are telling those Buddhist monks that Buddhist culture is also part of the Bhagavad Gita, and it's for people to know the science of the truth of the universe. And most of these people in the temple, they accept this method. So I want to ask a guru, Can you give us any special instruction? Are there any special instruction you want to give us?
No, I don't want to comment on this. This is unusual method of preaching. We don't have any real connection with Buddhism. Buddha rejects the Vedas. Although some principles are the same, there's a lot of difference between Krishna consciousness and Buddhism. So you can try for some time to preach like that, but that will not last very long. It's not going to be a very permanent method of preaching.
您可以用这种方法试着传播一段时间，但是这不会长久下去的，这不是一种永恒的方法，传播的方法。
But for some time, you can try.
您可以尝试一段时间。
See. Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个，第四个，在浩如烟海的 Krishna 世界面前，有时候觉得自己匮乏无力，不知道从何开始，不知道怎能取悟，请古鲁力训示，明白古莲花主。So, I feel very incompetent in front of Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness is like a vast ocean of knowledge. I don't know from where to begin and how to teach Guru generally. Please give me instruction of listening to the Guru's lotus feet detail.
Well, you just have to be patient and you have to follow the process of hearing and chanting. And you hear and chant regularly, gradually you'll build a firm foundation to your bhakti yoga, to the practice of Krishna consciousness. It will take some time, but you have to be regular, hearing and chanting.
你需要耐心，要遵守这个聆听和唱诵的方法，要打下坚实的风爱瑜伽的基础。
And you need to get good association with nice devotees who can guide you. They can teach you how to cook nicely and how to offer your food to Krishna and how to make a nice altar to worship Krishna. Be patient studying the philosophy. It will take some time before you become familiar with the knowledge of Krishna consciousness.
请耐心，学习这门哲学呢，它是要花时间的，要熟悉。
But continually continue to hear and to discuss in the association of devotees.
请继续在奉献者的联谊之下聆听讨论。
And keep this humble mood. This humble mood is very nice. Humility is a very important quality in advancing in Krishna consciousness. Always remain humble and consider yourself the servant. Don't try to become the master.
请继续保持谦卑的心态，您的谦卑心态非常好。谦卑对于在Krishna世界当中取得进步至关重要的，请继续保持谦卑，这种仆人的心态，不要试图做主人。Okay,
下一个问题。
Yuna, Hare Krishna, Kumar, and dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisance, all glory to Srila Prabhupada. Hiranyakashipu was jealous of Vishnu. When devotees are envious of each other, is their envy a reflection of Hiranyakashipu's envy? 这个问题来自 Yuna, Hare Krishna, Kumar. 奉献者们，请接受我卑微的礼拜，荣耀归于释迦牟尼佛。既然让喀什库嫉妒毕士努，当奉献者们彼此嫉妒的时候，他们的嫉妒是不是毗沙喀什库的嫉妒的反射呢
？Yes, it's demonic. We shouldn't envy other devotees. We should appreciate other devotees.
是的，这种嫉妒心是恶魔品性。我们不要嫉妒，要欣赏奉献者。Yeah.
It's a big difference. Just try to appreciate other devotees. Lord Krishna doesn't like envy.
这有很大的区别。一定要去，只要去欣赏奉献者。
就昆士呢不喜欢嫉妒。下一个问题。下一个华为五，今天庆祝节日，没有主女生儿的立体神像，只有照片或者塑材料，怎么沐浴呢？必须要沐浴吗？沐浴有要求吗？水、蜂蜜、牛奶，按照崇拜顺序沐浴吗？能否精简？用水可以吗？嗯，Prahlada的字面意义是什么呢？
Today is the festival. We don't have the deity form of Lord Nishina Dev. We only have picture form or those form that made of the other of the city. Not metal, not wood.
Not what?
They only have picture of Lord Nishina Dev and
they don't have a material form. They don't have a deity.
They don't have a deity. They only have picture and have just need to check this word. Jeffati. Resin. The material is made from resin. You know that, Maharaj?
Resin.
Yeah, resin, yes.
Synthetic. Resin. So it's, yes, synthetic material. Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So, what we asked, so, how to base this and should we base them? Definitely based on any requirements.
Well, what you can do, you hold a mirror in front of the picture. You hold the mirror, you reflect the picture in the mirror, and you bathe the mirror.
就把那个镜子放在这个面前，然后给这个镜子沐浴。
Lord Nisringa Dev can appear in the mirror, the reflection. You bathe the reflection.
Lord Nisringa Dev can appear in the mirror, the reflection. You bathe the reflection. So you mean that the devotee should bathe the mirror, right?
Yeah.
That pour the water, honey, milk.
Yeah, but at the same time, the reflection of Lord Nisringadev has to be there in the mirror. Then you bathe the reflection in the mirror.
Okay. So this devotee asked, is it a must that we face face?
No, not a must.
不是必须的。
The main thing, the must is that you discuss, you talk about Lord Nisringadev and you chant the name of Lord Nisringadev and you offer a feast. Okay.
Are there any sequence of the basting the material? Water, honey, milk? Should we follow the sequence of the basting the deity?
Usually begin with milk, and then begin with milk, and then the last one is water.
一般来说就是从牛奶开始，最后呢是以水结束。
And the other things doesn't matter.
就是无所谓。
Okay.
He asked, "Can we base only by water?"
Yes.
可以只用水沐浴。
But I said you don't need to bathe at all.
Sorry?
They don't need to bathe at all. They can just...
Okay, 就是根本就不需要沐浴。
下一个问题。
下一个。Palad 的字面意思是什么意思？What's the literary meaning of blood?
I don't know.
The next one. Yogita Sharma, Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept my humble obeisances. As the demons are knowledgeable of the soul and the super soul, do they know that Lord Vishnu is the super soul?
Yes.
是的，他们知道主位。我先翻一下。Hare Krishna Gurudev， 请接受前面顶拜。恶魔知道灵魂和超灵，他们知不知道主位是能就是超灵呢？回答是也是的。
Mm-hmm.
Because if they know, how did he think of killing him and sucking his blood？ 因为如果他们知道的话，他们怎么会想出要杀死他、喝他的血呢
？Because of demons.The demons are thinking like that. Whoever is my enemy, I'll have him killed. Okay. 下一个。
下一个，唐继东，顶拜孤儿莲花，您好，给总理圣号殿献花有什么要求吗？为什么？唐继东 ask.Basis to course lotus feet. Are there any requisites to offer flower to Nisringadev? What's the reason behind it?
Anyone?
Offering of flowers.
When?
Today, maybe today, he didn't say when. He just said, she just asked. Are there any rules for offering of flowers to Lord Shinade? Also, why?
Well, Lord Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, you can offer leaf, flower, fruit, water. But the main thing is there should be offered with love and devotion. So you want to offer flowers to Lord Nrisingadev? You have to have love and devotion. That's the main thing.
So Krishna said,
If you want to offer flowers, they should be fragrant, they should be fresh, and they should have a nice smell. Shaigawanti.
Prabhupada said, who taught him Krishna, who taught him knowledge about Bhakti Yoga? Why didn't Prahlad tell his father, Narada Muni? Is he want to protect his spiritual master?
Well, he doesn't need to protect Narada Muni, but he said that he was explaining the principle, the spiritual principle, that you don't get Krishna consciousness just simply on its own. And you don't get it just by being with others. You have to get it from somebody who's actually a devotee.
Maharaj and all devotees, why the demons always try to prevent devotees from association and prevent the devotees from doing yagya? Because devotee association can even purify demons.
Yeah, but demons don't want purified. They don't want what you say is purification. That's not what the demons want. Just like the demons, they like to suck blood. Hiranyakashipu said he likes to suck blood. He said his brother Hiranyaksha also liked to suck blood. That is their enjoyment. What you want is a different thing. So they don't want your enjoyment. They want their own enjoyment.
Next one. Yeah. 我分不清楚是在做服务的时候是在满足 Krishna 感官，还是在满足自己的感官。请问 Guru 有什么办法可以区分吗？ So Tom said Hare Krishna basis to the lotus feet of Guru. Many times I cannot distinguish whether I'm satisfying Krishna's senses or satisfying my own senses.Are there any good method to distinguish it? Because when doing service, we have our own inclination habits.
Well, you want to satisfy the guru and satisfy the devotees. Have you satisfied the devotees and satisfied the spiritual teacher? Then Krishna is satisfied.
那您就应该是把满足咕噜、满足奉献者放在心中，因为如果咕噜和奉献者得到满足了 ，Krishna 就满足了。
We don't want to be independent. We don't want to just do things on our own, but we want to consult with guru and sadhus and take advice from them and please them, and then you know that you're pleasing Krishna.
我们不要独立行事，自己做埋头做事情。我们应当咨询咕噜，我们应当参照经典的建议。只有我们取悦了咕噜，奉献者才能够取悦 Krishna。
Yes。
下一个是真真，顶拜咕噜莲花族，顶拜所有的奉献者，请问咕噜。Sita and Radharani the Kshatriya? So, Jinjin, they are basically to you, she asked, is Sita and Lakshmi, are they the incarnation of Radharani?
Yes, all female forms are expansions of Radharani.
是的，所有女性的形象都是施玛蒂拉德拉尼的扩展。
Mm-hmm.
下一个，阿帕米什尔布，顶拜库玛拉，感恩您。伊兰亚卡西布把本拉的送进恶魔学校，请问如果奉献者在中国生孩子，应该送孩子去咕噜库勒灵师学校还是现代世俗学校？选择和判断的标准是什么？阿帕米什尔布塞德的。Obeisance to Kumar. Since Hiranyakashipu sent Kalad to the demon school, but if devotees in China they have their own baby, should they send their babies to the children to Gurukula or the spiritual school or the modern mundane school? And what is the standard of theselection and what's the standard of the judgment?
Yes, it's certainly good if your child can go to a spiritual school to get association with devotee children. That's the best.
如果您能把孩子送到灵师学校，让孩子和奉献者的孩子联谊是最好的。
We know that when children go to mundane educational schools, they will get the very bad association and they'll learn all kinds of bad habits and mundane knowledge. We
know that when children go to mundane educational schools, they will get the very bad association and they'll learn all kinds of bad habits and mundane knowledge. 我们知道，当孩子们进入到世俗的教育学校的话，他们就会得到怪的联谊，不良习性以及糟糕的知识。
But it's not easy to organize Gurukula.
但是呢，组织 Gurukula 临时学校不是件轻而易举的事儿。
Mm-hmm. Okay.
下一个，华为五，讨论、唱诵、供奉、动力身哈是主要的，沐浴不是主要的。So this is the devotee to repeat your reply for his question about the basing of the devotion. He said that it's not important, it's not primary for the basing, Abhishek. and about the milk and water and that, and milk and water is not, doesn't matter, and we don't even need to base. The next one is the 下一个 novel. 明白顾着刘汉祖今天是主权并不显现日，意识到皇后身体不好，能提前荣耀吗？ A listen to Guru's daughter's feet. Today is the appearance day of Lord Xingde. We should fast until the evening. If our health is not good, can we honor Prashadam in advance?
Yes.
可以提前荣耀. Are there any bad effects for our spiritual practice?
You can just pray to Lord Narsingadev, tell him that you're sorry, that your health is not good and you have to eat, and ask him to forgive you.
Krishna, 请问 Maharaj 和所有的奉献者的莲花族， 请问 Maharaj, Prahlad 和 Hirakashu 代表什么角色？ So, obeisance to Guru Maharaj and all devotees look at speed. What did Prahlad and Hirakashu represent? What kind of role that did they represent?
Hiranyakashipu represents the typical materialist who's very attached to sense gratification and to his own body. And Prahlad represents the devotee.
And she continued to ask about the worship of Lord Nishinadev. Why should we offer fragrant oil?
Why should we offer fragrant oil? We offer fragrant oil for the pleasure of the deity, for the pleasure of Lord Narsingadev or Lord Krishna.
供奉香油是为了取悦神像，取悦主，你是那对主，取悦Krishna。Yes,
everything is offered for the pleasure of Krishna, right? So Krishna also likes fragrant oil.
供奉的一切目的都是为了取悦Krishna，难道不是吗？ 所以供奉香，因为主Krishna喜欢香油。Shai
Gavanti.
That's all for today.
Really? Okay.
Yes.
So we will stop here.
Now Janaka Prabhu, there is another question now.
Okay, Jigashin Swihok, Shai Gavanti.
Okay. 请拜顾莲花祖，请问，布拉德五岁写出那么多精彩祈祷文，收录在《普加瓦坛》第七篇，这些祷文是他自己写的呢，还是维亚塞德布帮他写的呢？ Obeisance to Guru's number three, Prahlad Maharaj, he's 5 years old, but he offers so much excellent prayer. It's included in Bhagavatam, the seventh canto. Are they written by
Vyasadeva,
or by his own?
They're spoken by Prahlad. Prahlad was given the power by the touch of Lord Narsingadev's lotus hand on his head. Lord Narsingadev put all spiritual knowledge into the head of Prahlad Maharaj so that he could offer these prayers.
Prahlad Maharaj 供奉的，因为女生的队伍，他把莲花手就放在了Prahlad的莲花。 头上就给了他这个力量，就把灵性知识注入到他的头脑之中，使得他可以供这些祷文了。
Yes, they're factual.
所以是真正的，这些是真真实实的祷文。
How does Vyasadeva know what Prahlad said? Because Lord Krishna is in his heart, and Vyasadeva is an empowered incarnation of the Lord, and Krishna tells him what Prahlad said.
那 Vyasadeva 又是怎么知道的呢？因为主 Krishna 在 Vyasadeva 心中，因为 Vyasadeva 是主的化身，所以在他内心的主 Krishna 就告诉了 Vyasadeva Prahlad 所说的话。
All right, so thank you very much for all your questions. Very nice. Ganshiyat Gurumani, Giwama Jintai Defanti, Ganshiyat Soya Defunctionsit, Wanti, Jufuniman, Jira Kwaila, Hare Krishna.
好，我们非常感谢圣 Bhakti Vishnuvinashana Sinha Swami.给我们带来的精彩的早课，还有这么耐心的所有对所有问题的那个谆谆教导，也感谢所有奉献者的耐心聆听和提问，希望大家能过一个愉快的，这个新年日，Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。